catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame later with them two-tone gates. Who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back.
You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you not went any inch of the real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh, chitty, chitty, bang, chitty, chitty, bang. Oh, them cannons ring, yes, them cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. And off we go from Las Vegas. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Fake the handoff. Now Carr. That's caught by Waller out left side. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that. How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got to like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Now they'll throw with Carr. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Darren Waller. the early lead. Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. And that makes it 7-0 Vegas. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 24. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Throwing, Prescott. He finds his target, it's Schultz. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll bring up second down. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard. Prescott to throw it. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Schultz. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, touchdown on the first drive, how about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
Prescott off play action. He'll buy some time right. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Here's Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds. A big play there on the catch and run.
This is what made the West Coast offense a staple around the NFL in the 80s and 90s. You don't have to push the ball deep downfield to come up with big plays, and there's an example of that right there.
They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. A good balance attack for that last. And now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defense.
Yeah, what's going on the defensive
side? That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 47. Now Carr. He finds his man complete. That's Jenkins. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
Good call there on 1st down. And Brandon, I'm getting better over the years and not screaming out screen, screen, screen with my defensive training. They want to keep those pass rushers honest. And they did so there, and they wind up picking up positive yardage.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Carr now on 1st down. I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Carr. And quickly into the hands of Waller. And the Raiders are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
Well, he does have one touchdown in the game already, and while this one won't go for six, it's enough to get him first and goal. But you and I both know he's going to be a little upset he didn't cross the goal line for a second time in this one.
Might want the ball here on the next play.
Again, it's Carr. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
We hear them discuss red zone efficiency a lot, CD, and they almost gave that one up in the red zone. Luckily, they'll have another shot.
And you and I both know that every offensive coordinator, play caller in the league, they take particular delight in their red zone calls because those are the payoff ones. But you can't call a play if your team doesn't have the ball. Got to secure.
And he finds Waller in the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Darren Waller with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Raiders have taken the lead. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Pollard to return from the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Now throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
He did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches' two-minute drill. To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Could be four down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. Now Prescott. Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down, Prescott. Completes it right side to Cooper. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here, complete. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Throwing again on second down, Prescott. He finds his man, complete. That's Lamb. And the Cowboys are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Now Elliott. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get this.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
Ezekiel Elliott with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. On the return, Tyron Johnson. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
But normally, you see three tight ends in a formation, you have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
And down to the 20, he'll go before heading out of bounds. A big play there for the Raiders.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Again, they'll throw with Carr. He'll get this underneath to Jacobs. Touchdown, Raiders! Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. And the Raiders have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. So 6 seconds, all that remains in this first half as the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. They'll roll him out right. He'll fire deep downfield from Lamb. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That is caught by Lamb. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Meanwhile, Dak's throw pulled in by Lamb. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Here's Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Meanwhile, Prescott's throw there caught by Gallup. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. And again, it's Prescott. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Draw play, Elliott. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and
and cut back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutral. Touchdown, Cowboys! Dak Prescott with a connection to CeeDee Lamb. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that will tie our game here in the third. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. Johnson now returning. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
They go back to the ground, this time Jacobs. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 48 yards rushing for him now to this point.
But I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Second and 11. On the handoff, this is Jacobs. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much through the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, if they want to ride him down the stretch, he should have fresh legs.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and 6. They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, sometimes, Brandon, it's just not a secret to how things get done. He's been running well all game long, and they continue to rely on him in this key situation.
They told us they were going to rely on him. They have. He comes through there, a big third down conversion. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Brent Urban there to get him down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
On second down, it's Barber. Calling a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've insured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. And in an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits zeros.
So it's Raider football as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal, looking to take the lead here in the late going. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. They'll run it with Jacobs, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Raiders answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. They get one more as the extra point's up and good, and they will take a 7-point lead. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Pollard to return from the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Dak connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Here's Dak. He finds his man complete. That's Lamb. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. The first down screen pass, good for 5. Inside of a minute to go now, 2 timeouts left, still in pretty good shape.
I think they're in excellent shape here if they use the timeouts judiciously and use the sideline as an additional timeout.
So 5 plays on this drive, Charles, all passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
And it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down 1. That extra point is not a gimme.
All right, so the Cowboys will go for 2 here. Now Prescott. Complete at the 1. And he is in for the 2. I still can't believe they went for it, but they've got themselves a lead here late in the ball game. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Now here's Johnson. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Throwing his car. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the 2-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up 2nd and 10. Carr to throw. Now into a sea of defenders and intercepted. picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And the Cowboys...